Hello students, welcome to EEP Archala. I am Dr. Khushbu Mahajan and I am working as a research associate in the Department of Political Science, and I am also working as Institute for Social Sciences and Research in the same university. Today we are going to discuss about the topic, the politics of new states. Since the inception of the independence, India has faced the demand of various states and the reorganization states on the basis of various grounds. First of all, on this basis, the States Reorganization Commission was organized in 1956. After that, there are many states which emerged after the demands of separate statehood by various regions. This was on the demand of, on the basis of language, on the basis of religion. But now there is a question, in recent times, what are the reasons for these demands? And it has been argued, as we discussed, by the various scholars that there are various reasons for the demand of different statehood by the different regions. And the basic reason behind is that, which is forwarded by the various scholars, that it is development, that the developmental backwardness in some regions led to the demand of separate statehood by the people of that area. And then another reason is the increasing importance of the state at the national politics. As the states, we know, in the era of coalition government, the states have gained much importance in the national politics. So these states have also acquired more economic power at the central level. Thus, in a way, they try to blackmail the central government by making such demands. But on the same side, it is also true that there is also economic backwardness in some areas of some regions, because of which the demand of separate statehood arise in these regions. Objectives: the manner in which linguistic reorganization of states took place, or the rules and for reorganizations, the spread of the demands of new states in India, the reasons behind new states in recent times, and why it has flourished in more recent times. What do the organizations generally allege? What is the social base of the organizations or the parties that demand separate states, or how much support do they enjoy? The States Reorganization Commission and the linguistic reorganization of the states. Although the government was not keen about linguistic reorganization, the demands for the reorganization on the basis of language kept on surfacing. The most severe demand was for the formation of Andhra state by separating Telugu speaking districts from Tamil speaking districts from Madras province. The Congress government led by Nehru was compelled to concede to this demand, and the state of Andhra Pradesh of October 1953. Due to this pressure, the Ministry of Home Affairs had to form the State's Reorganization Commission on 29th of December 1953, which was known as State's Reorganization Commission. Task of providing guidelines, recommendations, and a workable framework to facilitate the process of reorganization of different states and their constitutive units. After working for 18 months, the Commission submitted its report in October. The report, which is a document representing the conclusions of the Commission. Immediately after that, the State Reorganization Act was passed. The 27 states that had existed before 1956 were reorganized as 14 states after States Reorganization Act of 1956 of the country's linguistic diversity. There also came into existence 9 union territories. In the decades that followed, more number of states was formed, like that of Maharashtra and Gujarat in 1960. Several states in the Northeast in the period between 1970s to 80s, Jharkhand in 2000, and the last, the state of Telangana in 2014. As it stands today, in the middle of 2017, Federal India consists of 29 states. The rules or principles used for reorganization. Indian politics. In his books, The Politics of India Since Independence in 1990, wrote that in the prolonged process of reorganization, the practice of Indian state had been coherent and almost consistent. He argued of four formal and informal rules in order to tackle the demand for separate states by linguistic organizations. To him, the first set of rules was the central government would not recognize groups which made secessionist demands but would suppress them. The rule followed from the bitter experience of partition and was the government would not accommodate regional demands based on religious differences. The third rule was that reorganization would not simply be done because of the presence of state, but the leadership of that language group should be in a position to able to mobilize and demonstrate support behind the demand. The fourth rule was that the central government would not agree to reorganization of a province if the demand was made. However, have not been followed all the time, particularly in the more recent periods. Why the demand for new states in recent times? Although the map of India had been redrawn several times over the years, sometimes to satisfy linguistic groups, multiplied over the years, and some demands are often incessant. Let us briefly look at the spread of the demands in contemporary India before we come to the reasons behind these demands. If the formation of these three separate states, Jharkhand in 2000, provided a boost to such demands in different parts of the country. The announcement by the Union Home Minister on 9th December 2009 to initiate the process of formation of a separate state of Telangana parts of the country. Many of the organizations renewed their demands and resorted to intense political activity. Interestingly, some of the regions which are being earmarked for the separate statehood are small in terms of physical deterred the ethnic mobilizers for raising claims for separate statehood, since in the past states which are small in size, for example the states in northeast and the last being the state of Uttarakhand in 2000, were formed even though they there exist several demands for separate states along with the demands for other forms of autonomy, the latter being more prominent in the northeast of India. Out of these demands, most of them are weak, do not have much support like that of Kozal movement in western part of separate state of Gorkhaland or the movement for separate state of Bodoland. Separate state of Bodoland, where the leaders have been able to mobilize considerable support among the ethnic community behind their demands. Autonomy for the region. It may also be pointed out here that even though some of the movements are strong enough in the sense that they have considerable popular support, but the organization's demand long point of time. Hence the movements keep on recurring more in brief spells. In the eastern part of India, there are several movements for separate states that can be identified. In the northern region of the West Bengal, there and the parts of the plains of Jalpaiguri and Darjeeling districts. Apart from this, there are also demands for the formation of a separate state of Kamtapur and Greater Kuch Bihar. The territorial there is a demand of the formation of separate state of Kosal in western Odisha and also an occasional demand for a separate state of Kalinga. Out of the two, the demand for a separate state of Kosal is much more organized. Separate state of Kalinga is mainly located in the southern region of Odisha, and territorial claims of the organization to some extent overlap with the claims of Kosal demanding parties and organizations. In Bihar, when one turns to Northeast India, one notes that it is complex in terms of its ethnic composition. It is said that Northeast India is homeland of cultural diversity, and it is inhabited by more organization in this region started in 1960s and 1970s, beginning with the bifurcation of Nagaland from Assam in 1962, when several states were formed later. But the several of these ethnic groups demand autonomy of all sorts. Northeast India thus is witnessing several movements, ranging from movements for political autonomy under the Sixth Schedule Mizo movements. Separatist movement first appeared in Nagaland and Mizoram, and then it spread to Manipur and Assam. In the state of Assam, apart from the separatist movement like that of by Ulfa, there and other groups, even though three autonomous councils, Bodoland Territorial Council, Karbi Anglong Autonomous Council, Dima Hasao District Autonomous Council had been formed. The demand is now being spearheaded by Kuki State Demand Committee, and which has resorted to long indefinite strikes and economic blockade periodically. This demand is in 1988, Poo Nehlun Kipgen had founded the Kuki National Front at Molnoy to fight for the state of Kukiland. Assembly. In southern part of India, demands for separate states, though, are not that threatening, but has recurred from time to time. Out of the movements, two movements in Tulu Nadu or Tulu Rajya, comprising of the northern part of Kerala, Dakshin Kannada, and parts of Udupi district, is gaining ground. And claims are made construct an identity through Tulu language and culture since 1990s. Hence, the linguistic and cultural argument, along with located in the southwestern part of Karnataka, and the current demand is being spearheaded by Coorg National Council. The contemporary Similarly, in Tamil Nadu, there exists a demand for creation of a separate state of Kongu Nadu on the basis of the claims that the Kongu Nadu region has autonomy. In the western region, there are several demands of separate states in all the states, out of which the state of Maharashtra, which is the largest This is happening even though people in all the regions have participated in the demand for Samyukt Maharashtra in 1950s. Out of all it's back to the British period, and even the State Reorganization Commission had recommended for it, but powerful forces had opposed. To them, development has got concentrated in the western region of the state, whereas the other regions, namely Konkan, mostly successful Vidarbha Band of November 27, 2000, supported by almost all the political parties except the Shiv Sena and the left. From the Vidarbha Rajya Sangharsh Samiti, there are other organizations like Vidarbha Rajya Gan Parishad and Vidarbha Mukti Morcha that also supported the band and meant in more recent times. Similarly, in neighboring Gujarat, there is a demand for separate state of Saurashtra. States had emerged in different regions of the country in the name of development, cultural distinctness, administrative convenience, history of separate existence, demands has coincided with the growth of importance of the states in Indian federal setup. A cursory look at the constitution and the review of resources. But the volume of resources which are at its disposal is huge. Hence the and a half decades, two crucial developments have taken place which had increased the importance of states in Indian federal arrangement. Firstly, regional parties at the state level, the importance of the states in national politics has increased. The states to us governments have become interestingly and important in themselves, and political parties battle fiercely at the state level for the purpose of the states, and the political power which states possess has increased over the years. As a result of all and this can be made out from the fact that there were a large number of organizations in India. Noted earlier that even though in the federal setup envisaged in the constitution, state governments appear to be states had control over the huge economic resources even before liberalization began and had considerable political. Had pursued policies for attracting more and more private investment, regional inequalities within regions of the states have increased considerably over the years since 1990s. This is, however, not are being set up are coming in the tribal inhabited backward regions, districts of the state. Only the regional disparities have got accentuated as a result of liberalization of economy. When some parts of the state have advanced more rapidly under the impetus of globalization, existing states to constitute new states, or at least for greater class of contractors or a class of businessmen, people associated with service sector, a new state is formed. For example, in November 2000, Gujarati and Sindhi communities who control the business for supporting the movement. Then it is the movement for a separate state of Telangana which continued to that are considered to be backward or underdeveloped within the state. Relies on linguistic and cultural lines and demand the formation of turn to a different set of questions now. What do they claim? Nations that demand separate states are couched in the theoretical argument of back. data that the region they inhabit in the state is backward or are considered as a function of the internal colonialism and neglect the region and inhabitants of the region. In Odisha, the process of economic. Similarly, in Vidarbha movement, the organizations leading the movement at thus, the issue of identity under the cases, the movements are sporadic in the brief spells, generally not in traders and a class of contractors, particularly in the town. Thus, it can be said that from the dominant we have discussed about the various demands of separate statehood by various regions of the country. Although whatever the reasons for these demands are, but this is a big threat to the unity and integrity to the nation. So to sum up, we can say that the reasons of these demands was economic or economic backwardness of some regions, but there are also some mischievous elements in certain states which highlight these demands, and there are also their personal interests of some groups, those who highlight these demands of the states. Thus, the state governments and the national government should take strict steps in this direction so that such demands should not pose a threat to the unity and integrity of the country.